So I got a call from a friend the other day.
Hey man, can you make me a realistic simulation in Blender with water moving objects around?
Yeah, I can do that. I think. Fuck! Come on, man. Just move. Got it. So after trying every way I could think of and searching for different methods, I was finally able to make it work by faking it.
Hey, this guy's a great big phony!
Hold on, you'll see what I mean. Blender uses flip to simulate fluid. Flip stands for fucking long iteration process. It makes a bunch of particles that follow the laws of physics, wrap a mesh around it, and when you add a water material to it, it will get rendered as water in your animation. After messing around a lot, I realized that the fluid simulator in Blender is one way only, meaning only the rigid body object, or the effector as they call it, can affect the fluid, not the other way around. So the fluid cannot move objects. But you know who can? Me. I animated the bucket tipping over, and when I started the simulation, the fluid followed the bucket animation. Voila! We have a realistic simulation. The water will flow out of the bucket realistically, or really close to it. But the animation of the bucket will be as realistic as I can animate it. This type of simulation where you fake it with an animation would be fine for video games or visual effects. But my friend needs the simulation to be as realistic as it gets. So we'll have to fill up the sandcastle bucket and have it tip over where the water physics decides to, not when the keyframe animates it. I guess I'll have to call my friend and tell him it's not possible. Or is it? I started searching for fluid simulator softwares and came across a few. The two softwares that stood out the most were RealFlow and Houdini. I heard a lot about Houdini for its visual effects praise, but never gave it a try. This might be a good opportunity to learn it. But there's also RealFlow, which is a software dedicated to simulate fluid. So if I use RealFlow, I will only need to learn the basic stuff to get my simulation going and I'll be done. It's funny to see how naive I can be sometimes. So this is when I dove into the rabbit hole of water physics. RealFlow has a 30-day demo which will give me plenty of time to try what I want. I loaded the software and I don't understand anything. Okay, there's a node system, I see a bunch of different particle types, emitters, objects. Let's start here. We'll import our mesh. They only accept a few types of files. I recognize OBJ, so I'll use this one. Let's go back inside Blender, export the right type of file, and import it in RealFlow. Alright, we got our mesh, now let's add the fluid. The water will come out of a hose, so let's add a circle emitter. A domain gets added, but my circle emitter is way too big, so I'll scale it down a bit to make it more realistic. And this was my first mistake. You'll see what I mean soon enough. There's a whole bunch of settings in here, and this is perfect for a simulation. But not so much for me, we'll have to go through all of them. I'll just get water flowing and go from there. Let's click simulate. Where's the fluid? Let's try it again. Nope, nothing. It seems like I'll have to start from the very basics. Let's add a sphere and see if I can get fluid come out of it. Okay, everything seems fine. Why is my circle emitter not working then? Remember when I told you scaling it down would be a problem? This probably has something to do with it. The solution here is to raise the resolution of the domain to get smaller particles. This way we might get a chance to get water. The resolution determines the size of your particles. The higher the number, the smaller the particles, but also the longer it will take to simulate. I finally got a few droplets when bumping up the resolution, but it's going right through the bucket. Wait, there's no rigid body attached to it? Easy fix. Okay, now we're good to go. I was having trouble with particles going through the mesh, but this was fixed by raising the minimum and maximum substeps. Substeps are the number of times a simulation gets calculated on every frame. So if you set substeps to 1, physics will be calculated once per frame. But if you set it to 5, it will get calculated 5 times and you'll get a more accurate simulation. So bumping up the substeps made the simulation work fine. But it was taking so much time. Fucking long iteration process. Yeah, the name fits perfectly. After playing around a few hours with RealFlow, I decided to give Houdini a try to see if it will be easier to make the simulation work. And I couldn't have been more wrong. Blender is like riding a bicycle. RealFlow is like driving a car. And Houdini is like flying a freaking space shuttle. I tried to use it with baby steps and just do the basic stuff to get where I wanted, but it seems like there's no basics in Houdini. You start a project and it's already hard mode. The simulation was almost working, but I was having a lot of trouble with the collisions, so I decided to put everything aside and I went back to real flow, which didn't seem too bad after all. The next day I was playing around in Blender and I had this idea to use a portion of the interior of the bucket as a fluid emitter in real flow. This way I would skip the long part where it fills up. This is where I realized how many variables in real flow I needed to change to get a realistic simulation. The mass of the bucket was 1 kg by default. This might be wrong. Is the center of gravity correctly placed? I don't know. How much surface tension should I apply? Is there enough drag force? What the hell is the internal pressure? I gotta go back inside Blender. Now there's even dual S physics, which I barely gave a try. But this one was like a flying saucer to me, and I was getting burned out from learning new softwares. So back in Blender, I had this last resort idea to use a specific amount of fluid and drop rigid bodies with the same amount of weight. Hey bud, I gave it a shot, but Blender cannot do it. And realistic fluid simulation is some engineering level type of work, so animating it is probably your best bet. I'm not sure Blender could have saved me if they had the feature to move objects with fluid, but it would have been easier to get into it, that's for sure. I kept playing around with fluid simulation and I feel more confident with it now, but realistic simulation is on a whole other level. Thanks for taking the time to watch this video, like the video if you enjoyed it, and I'll be making more Blender and game dev related videos, so subscribe if you're interested. See ya!